In the midst of the church, he opened his mouth, and the Lord filled him with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we gather for this Eucharist, today in the liturgy of the Church, we celebrate the memorial of Saint Athanasius. We pray through his intercession. Let us now pause for a moment in the silence of our hearts, presenting our personal prayer, our intention that we bring to God's altar. We pray offering this Mass in the following intentions. I pray for the repose of the soul of Giuseppe Di Franco, the Mass requested by Maria Donata Maffei and family. And Father Pavel is praying, offering this Mass for the repose of the soul of Marlene Dejeuner, the Mass requested by beloved husband. Let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who raised up the Bishop Saint Athanasius as an outstanding champion of your Son's divinity, mercifully grant that rejoicing in his teaching and his protection, we may never cease to grow. We may never cease to grow in knowledge and love of Christ. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The church throughout Judea, Galilee, and Samaria had peace and was built up. Living in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit, it increased in numbers. Now as Peter went here and there among all the believers, he came down also to the saints living in Lydda. There he found a man named Aeneas, who had been bedridden for 8 years, for he was paralyzed. Peter said to him, "Aeneas, Jesus Christ heals you. Get up and make your bed." And immediately he got up. And all the residents of Lydda and Sharon saw him and turned to the Lord. Now in Joppa there was a disciple whose name was Tabitha, which in Greek is Dorcas. She was devoted to good works and acts of charity. At that time, she became ill and died. When they had washed her, they laid her in a room upstairs. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples who heard that Peter was there sent two men to him with the request, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter got up and went with them. And when he arrived, they took him to the rooms upstairs. All the widows stood beside him, weeping and showing tunics and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was with them. Peter put all of them outside, and then he knelt down and prayed. He turned to the body and said, "Tabitha, get up." Then she opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hand and helped her up. Then calling the saints and widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
What return can I make to the Lord for all that he gives to me? What return can I make to the Lord for all that he gives to me? What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. What return can I make to the Lord for all that he gives to me? I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. What return can I make to the Lord for all that he gives to me? O Lord, I am your servant, the child of your serving girl. You have loosed my bonds. I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. What return can I make to the Lord for all that he gives to me?
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the people, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you." When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you there are some who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones who did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, as we continue reading from John's chapter 6, the teaching on the bread of life, we may have some doubts, like the disciples who reacted to Jesus in today's gospel. In fact, many disciples stopped following Jesus because they struggle to understand and accept his hard saying. They reply to this teaching This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it? Brothers and sisters, many times we struggle ourselves. Maybe not necessarily to accept the teaching, but sometimes we just struggle to pay the full attention, to concentrate on the Eucharist, on the Mass. But the Lord gives us His Spirit that He promised, that He will intercede on our behalf, that He will help us to understand the whole truth. So today, when Jesus turns to His closest friends, the apostles, and asks if they were also to leave, St. Peter's powerful words serve as a reminder for all of us, for all Christians. Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We can wonder, as we reflect upon this teaching, why the gift of the Eucharist has been from the very beginning a source of contention, a source of division, misunderstanding. Why have we from Jesus' time to the present day been fighting over it? Shouldn't it be the source of our unity and deepest joy? Well, yes, of course. But we can't overlook the fact that it is always divided. It has always divided, just as Jesus Himself divided people. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. Yes, we cannot compromise. We cannot say that it is okay that you believe that the Eucharist is just a mere symbol or some kind of image. We truly believe that the Eucharist is the true body and blood, soul and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if we truly believe that Jesus has words of eternal life, words that demand we love God, love our neighbor, and yes, eat His flesh and drink His blood in the Eucharist, then we, like Tabitha from our first reading, will experience the merciful power of God. Our death will be a birth into new life, and at the end of time, our earthly bodies will also be raised and glorified. Let our prayer today be twofold. May we pray for the grace to live more like Tabitha, doing good works, giving alms, out of love for God. And two, that we may truly believe St. Peter's declaration that Jesus has the words of eternal life. May we truly believe that Jesus, the Son of God, wills eternal life for all of us, and that His promises are true. Following the example of St. Athanasius, who faithfully served the Lord and trusted in Him throughout his life, we now bring our needs to God.
For the leaders of the Church, may the Holy Spirit continue to give them strength and grace in proclaiming the truth fearlessly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle each day to feed themselves or their families, May God give them strength and lift them from their difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healthcare workers who are selflessly treating coronavirus patients during this pandemic, may God grant them fortitude and deliver them safely at the end of each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those infected with or recovering from the coronavirus, may Jesus, the divine physician, offer them hope and provide healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed,
in a special way, the souls of Giuseppe DiFranco and Marilyn Dejeuner, for whom we offer this Holy Mass today.
May they rest in the peace of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Lord place his hand upon us and guide us in our service to the sick, oppressed, or suffering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our own personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Eternal Father, we trust in your infinite goodness and love. Kindly hear our prayers, which we ask in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church. Look, O Lord, upon the offerings we present to you in commemoration of St. Athanasius, and may witnessing to your truth bring salvation to those who profess, as he did, an unblemished faith, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Athanasius you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy love. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Athanasius, Saint Pio, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us now pray together an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, Almighty God, that the true divinity of your only begotten Son, which we firmly profess with St. Athanasius, may through this sacrament ever give us life and protection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us glorify the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God.